now. Goodness me. Go!
Darn your old man, stop!
I just clean your own doorstep.
I'm gonna housekeeper that leaves her doorstep till Sunday afternoon.
Oh.
Maybe that's when you do your doorstep. I do mine in the morning before you man are even awake.
Hey.
Now you say we women have got no place serving on boards and thinking about politics.
Yes.
But what's politics? It's just housekeeping on a big scale.
Not me.
Those of you that give your wives your wages.
Oh, that's your money!
Lord High Housekeeper of England.
If it was only to use for our comfort, do you think many of you working men would be found turning over your wages to your wives?
No.
No? What's the reason thousands do? The best and the soberest. It's because the working man knows that what's a pound to him is 20 shillings to his wife. And she'll make every penny, every one of them shillings tell.
That's right.
She'll get more for him out of his wages than what he can. Now some of you know what the home is like when the men don't let the woman manage.
Oh, that.
Well, the poor laws of the old government are just in the same muddle because the men have tried to do the national housekeeping without the women.
Come on. 1905, with no assurance that if we went on the same way, that any girl born in this world, in this generation, would live to exercise the rights of citizenship, though she lived to be 100. So we asked ourselves, had this all been in vain?
Yeah.
There must be some better way. And we thought to ourselves, well, what did the working men do to get the vote?
We
looked to our records and we saw in the history books that what they did was
not by scratching their faces.
That we want to follow such a violent example, we much rather not. But if violence is the only way to make this country see we're in earnest, we are prepared to show them.
And they'll show you. They'll lock you up.
Don't think that going to prison holds any fears for us. We'd go for life if we need freedom for the rest of women.
Why don't the men help you to get your rights?
Someone here is asking why the men don't help. It's partly they don't yet understand. And it's partly that the men don't yet understand what's at stake for all of us.
He said, thinking that they can get
And partly it's because the bravest man is afraid of ridicule.
Hey.
Oh yes, we've heard so much all our lives about the timidity and sensitiveness of women.
Yeah.
And indeed, we are sensitive. Mm-hmm. But I tell you, ridicule crumbles a man. It steals a woman.
Yeah.
Unconscious friend. For who trolls, who cartoons someone who's of no importance? What advertisement is so sure of being remembered?
I admit that.
And if we didn't know it by any other way, it's through the comic papers that we show that we've arrived. But our greatest debt of gratitude we owe to that man who called us nasty women. We aren't nasty women, but we hope that the fact will be forgiven. For if we were nice, well-behaved women, who would come to see us? Not the men. They say it is unwomanly for us women to care about politics. But what would they know about what's womanly? Leave it to the women to decide that. And let the men attend to being manly. It'll take all their time. And they say it would be disgraceful if we got the vote because then we'd be pitted against men in the economic struggle. But that has come about already. Did you know that out of every 100 women in this country, 82 are wage-earning women? Indeed. And people say that it's feminine for women to be educated, to aspire to the arts, to bring fame and fortune. But no one ever said it was unfeminine for women to do the heavy drudgery that's badly paid. And the men didn't hanker after it. Oh, no.
She can talk a little more, Cat.
They can all talk.
I don't want to be her husband. They can come home to that.
Justice, then why don't you go to the House of Lords?
Sorry.
Better hurry up in case early closes.
You can ask any question you like at the end of the meeting.
Oh, questions?
Oh, no. I have
questions. That's why she's here. I got questions.
She might have been faculty.
I suppose so.
Ah, so someone definitely so disappointed. I did hope we'd hear one of the worst.
Can you tell me, my friend, who makes the disturbances?
Oh, the one that's doing the talking. She's the disturbing us a lot.
We have a man over here asking.
Hey, I got a question too. Are you married?
Quick, here's your chance. He's a bachelor.
Man over here asking, if women get the vote and have full franchise, and war is declared, will they fight?
Oh no.
And some say the problem with us is that we do fight. But that's not to say that we women fight for the sake of fighting. We only do it out of hard necessity. We women are for peace. And once we women have a share of the public affairs, there'll be less likelihood of war. That's not to say that we women can't fight, oh no. Women all over the world have been fighting the forces of colonialism and patriarchy. We women fight for justice, and we are for peace. Our part, we're proud to say it, our part's to go after you men in the wartime and to pick up the pieces. We go high.
Nothing reprehensible to what she said, was there?
Oh, reprehensible.
She makes me rather miserable.
should hope not, indeed.
Nice to watch it,
to make nice little speeches with composure, so I did. I said that you have very pink cheeks. Well, I'll stick to that. And you're the only female creature I ever did see who didn't look frightened over things.
Glad to know that you're frightened.
Oh.
Jolly good fellow, all right?
Oh, no, he ain't good. He's jolly is because he thinks you're such a silly codfish, you're gonna go swell in his majority again. And does any liberal leader jolly to see cheap folk like you looking on, proud and happy, when you see liberal leaders deserting liberal principles? You show me a liberal, and I'll show you a Mr. Face in both ways, yes! He sheds the light of his warm and handsome smile over the working man, but around the other side, he's tipping a wink to the great landowners. That's to show him he's standing between them and the socialists. Oh, yes.
Socialists.
The liberal. He's a judicial sort of chap that sits in the middle.
On the fence.
Oh, yes, on the fence. Well, toys on one side, socialists on the other. It's not always nice being in the middle. Your life will get squeezed!
Now, I say to the women, the conservatives don't promise you much, but what they promise, they do.
Here, this guy's not half bad.
The liberal, he'll promise you the art, then he'll give you the whole of nothing.
Isn't this fun? Aren't you glad I brought you?
This job's rather amusing.
We work in them, we've seen this happen over and over again, but the women, they can take a hint quicker than what we can, can't they? They won't stand for the nonsense the men do. Only they don't even have a chance to agitate for their rights. You know, as I was coming up here, I heard a man say, why, look at this crowd. We're all men.
Yeah.
If the women want the vote, why ain't they here to say so?
Yes.
Well, I'll tell you why. It's because they spent all afternoon getting dinner for you and me, and now they're back home doing the dishes.
Do you think we should do the wash?
Well, if they left it up to us once or twice, we might understand more about the women question than we do now. I know my wife isn't here. Because she knows I'm on my juice around the house. She's hoping I can speak to some purpose. Well, maybe she's mistaken. But I've come here today to show my support for her and all the other women. And to tell you all what changes you can expect to see when women ask the same big share in public affairs that they have to have.
What do you know about it? You can't even talk grammar.
I'm not here to talk grammar, but to talk report. I ain't defending my grammar, but I'll say in passing that if my mother had had her rights, maybe my grammar wasn't been better.
Oh, I got a question. Hey.
Now wait half a minute, my man.
Hey, who you calling your man? I ain't your man.
Much about women.
Hey, I'm married.
Oh, the gentleman says he's married. Well, for the sake of his wife, we shouldn't be too sorry he's here. No doubt she's sitting at home saying, oh, heaven be praised.
great, there's a demonstration going on, and I'll have a quiet Sunday night for one night of my life.
You're like that fella at Hammersmith. He was telling me, how would you like it if the women stayed home to do the family wash? I told him, well, I wouldn't advise it. I've got too much respect for my clothes.
The women ought to be doing the washing. It's their place.
Yes.
I ain't sure you ain't right, but I mean, from the look of you, as many of you can't even wash yourself.
Who is you talking to? Which of us do you mean?
Well, I mean, given the way you were chirping the women earlier, and the fact that it takes 10 of that kind of sort to make a man, you may take it to mean I mean a lot to you.
But I should like to ask, in return, since when has society been held to exist for its handful of geniuses?
How many Platos are there here in this crowd? Not one.
But that doesn't give you men off the register. How many Shakespeares are there in all of England today? But society doesn't tumble to ruin. Railroads and ships are built. Babies are born, homes are kept going. The world goes on. It goes on by virtue of its common people. It doesn't concern me that you should think we women can compose immortal music, or write good books, or paint great pictures, though we can do that too. It concerns me that you should class us with the common people who keep the world going. But I should like the world to do a great deal better. I've been inquiring into the type of lodging available for the poorest class of women in this great city, but I found that only the men of that class are provided for. The women are still recommended to rely on the chivalry of men. Justice and chivalry. The two both remind me of the account lately in the police court news of the young girl being tried for the murder of her child up in Manchester. Not pleasant reading. This, as you'll remember, was a young working girl, an orphan of 18. And she crawled the dead body of her baby to her master's back door and left it there. She hauled herself off a little ways and fainted. 2 days later, she found herself in the police court being tried for the murder of her child. Her master, a married man, of course reported the find at his back door to the police, and he was summoned to the court to get evidence. And she called out to him in front of the open court, "You are the father." He couldn't deny it. The coroner, at the jury's request, censored the man, but regretted that he could not be held legally responsible. He got off scot-free, and that young girl now serves her sentence up in Strange Ways Jail.
Why are you disliking her so?
Why should you think it's
something? I never saw you look at you two.
You men boast that an English citizen is tried by his peers. Which woman is tried by hers? A woman is arrested by a man, brought before a man judge, tried by a jury of men, condemned by a man, sent to prison by a man, and by a man she is hanged.
Yeah!
Where in all of this are her peers?
Right there.
A man's peer is the best judge of the degree of his guilt, his temptation. What man here can properly judge a woman's deeds in that time of anguish that some woman went through to put each man here into this world? I noticed that when a previous speaker quoted the Labour Party, some of you applauded.
Yes!
I take it some of you consider yourselves Labour men?
Yeah!
Every woman who was born a child is a Labour woman.
Oh!
What man is a fit judge of what she goes through, her deeds, in that time of anguish, that hour of darkness when even under the best conditions that money and devotion can buy, many a woman falls into temporary mania and not a few go down to death. In the case of that poor, little, abandoned working girl, what man can properly judge her deeds in that moment of half-crazed temptation? Women know of these things as those know burning who have walked through fire.
Oh.
We women must organize. Mm-hmm. We must learn to work together. Yeah. We have worked for so long and so exclusively for men, we no longer know how to work together. But we must learn. Those who can may give money.
Why
those of you are so poor you can't show some part of your support through your labor?
Yes, all that money.
Oh yes, I hope you'll all join the union. Please come up after the meeting and give me your names.
I can tell you won't get any men.
The women I appeal. I'm not saying this work wouldn't be done better together, shoulder to shoulder. But the mass of men won't have it so. I only hope they realize in time the goodness they've renounced and the spirit they've aroused. For I know as well as any man could tell me, it would be a bad day for England if all women felt about men as I do.
Oh.